Hello and welcome back to a fabric place, Mordheim, City of the Damned. We are still continuing with the Witch Hunters, of course, and I'm actually recording this video the day after the last Witch Hunter video because, as you all might remember, we just got our impressive, the Exectunioner, and I'm just very... It's itching in my fingers to try him out. I'm a little bit worried that we're going to meet enemy impressives now, but I also just want to see what he can do in action, so I couldn't help myself but just go for another episode right away, pretty much. So if anybody has already claimed a name for him, I'm sorry that that is not in yet, and so that will have to wait a little bit longer, but I'll get there, I promise, if that is indeed the case. So... let us take a quick look here. I gave Leonhardt light armor because he's still got 70% dodge with this, and he just looks awesome with the... and heavy armor would be even cooler, I think, or would look even better. But I'd like, or we need to get him armor proficient for that first, and I'm not really sure I want to give him heavy armor, but we'll see. But it would look really nice, for sure. And aside from that, I gave all the flagellants that we have with us a one-handed weapon now. There were was still one with a two-handed weapon, so now we do have the two single attacks on them as well. So we do need to move on one day. And let's see, this is all fine. And we have now received a new mission request from the Grand Theogenes. So our second story mission is available. And we've also got money for our shipment requests. Available. So Loathsome Lore. The Sword of Zinch recovered by the Warband has been studied. And it's called an Altov. They have determined that the blade is more than enchanted. Powerful demon has been bound to it. It is feared that this Transitron will free the demon. From the one titled Demonomicon. Both sword and demon. Oh boy, yeah. More complete copy of the book was in Mordheim's great library. So this, I knew that this would happen already, at least the map. The second story mission will take us into the library. And I hate the library. I don't want to do that. We could already go for it, and we're probably going to go for it maybe next time or the time after that. Because we can, with the rating that we have, and if I go for the our best ranked units already, our rating will be even higher. But not today, and the library is just so annoying. So let's see, we do have three brutal missions. And at least two of which... I like a lot. So both warbands deploy tightly around their wagon. Prefer to face each other. This is the White Ark. Yeah, we're going to go for Rivals in the Ruins. Exceptional Wordstone Rush with both warbands deploying tightly around their wagons. That is perfect. The White Ark would be awesome as well, but that's only good Wordstone. Well, here we have Exceptional, and both are Wordstone Rush, so I'm fine either way. So we will be going for that, and we will be right back with the deployment. And here we go. Only 45% of Wordstone is needed today, so not quite that much, I assume. So let's take a quick look here. There isn't actually a lot of Wordstone on the map. And the map itself isn't that big either, so we're going to be on each other fairly quickly. Let me remove this one back here, we won't get that anyways. Come on, and put it here. So they are right up there, and we are down here, so where can I set up my Exectunioner? These spots, let's go there. And then let's see. I'd like for you to be right over here so that we can go through that building and into... or no, all the way up in front is better than you here. Let's put the leader a little bit further back and the other ones as well. I'd like for our slower units to be up front if possible. Or at least somewhat up front, especially Peter. And then Black Orb right there. Okay, So I have no idea what we're playing against. And let's see, we probably, yeah, let's do that. Ferric is going to go over there, I guess. But how do I want to get there? So that's all shards over there, I think. And yeah, let's just put him here as a sort of scout. He will be the first one to see anything that moves towards us. So Eberhard will go... left here towards the Wordstone that is right around the corner. And that is two shards and a fragment. So not that good, actually, for exceptional Wordstone. No clusters in sight yet, interestingly enough. So, let's see. Our morale is a bit better than our opponent's, so that doesn't really tell us much. And where do we want to go? Leonhard, probably this way. As that is where this Wordstone appears to be. I'm not really sure yet how we can reach it, but we're just going in the right direction, I think. And I'm going to move most of the warband down the middle, as it will allow us to react pretty fast to any sort of shenanigans our enemy might be up to. And it just keeps this in line, so we can probably go for this, and then this, or maybe this here, that's what I mean. The question is, can we get the 10 Wordstone? That's probably not going to be that easy, because a good chunk of it appears to be a little bit closer to their side. But it depends on how fast they will approach us. So I'm not really sure. And can the Executioner pick up items? I think so. He does have an inventory, a backpack, yeah. It's consumable quest items carried. We'll see. So let's move forward. Wow, that's quite the stompy sound that he makes. That's impressive, literally. So his name is quite the description there. And he just looks extremely menacing with that face mask and the leather jerkin. Is that the right word? It's not something I usually say, but I think that's how you can describe it. Okay, that's fun. So it's witch hunters against witch hunters, and that is the enemy impressive already. So he probably started somewhere over here. But this will also make it a lot more difficult for us to get the Wordstone that we want. Because they're just right there already. And the Wordstone is a little bit off to the side. So we'll have to wait and see if we can snag that or not. So right into it completely. Enemy warband with an impressive, same as ours, so that's going to be fun. And maybe put Ray... No, we can't actually go through there, even though that door is indeed open. So let's see, cast Immaculate Flesh on Ferric. Give him Wordstone resistance. Really? But yeah, that's unfortunate. That's going to cost us an attack for a round or two if we already get into close combat with him. Might actually not be the worst idea to just attack their impressive with our impressive and then move in with our other units. But we'll have to wait and see what they do first. They probably won't let me do that quite that easily. And Peter is just going to trot forwards towards the enemy. His heavy armor is protection enough, I guess. Or it should be. And Black Orc, oh, of course, I ran past that with three units. Hit it with the fourth one. As always. So two more for them. And what will happen next? Well, the new round will begin. That's pretty obvious. So we only see him. 464 hit points? How much does ours have? 285. That's a difference. Oh, there's their guy. So, oh God. Can I can go for this. And we do see more of them. But do I dare to go for this? We can definitely get this one. If objectives I can get that updated with a little bit of shimmying, so that I can still have one strategy point over or left to back off again a bit, objectives updated, that would be ideal. Okay, actually did work out, objectives, and we got three shards. Updated. I always feel a bit bad when I do this. But why not? I think it's still okay to do stuff like this. Okay, and we are going to go right here and ambush. I'm really not happy that their impressive is right there. This being a brutal mission. Objectives he's just updated going to deal a lot of damage, and he's carrying a two-handed weapon on top of everything, so his damage should be quite devastating.
Objectives updated.
Objectives fragments, so we updated have 6 out of the 10 wordstone that we need. I'm not really sure we're going to keep it all because one of our flagellants might go down. Is this the right direction? It appears to be, okay. And hopefully nobody will come this way and catch him alone and off guard. But let's just see what they end up doing before we do stuff. And I might just delay with our impressive so that we act after theirs. That way we can attack him after he comes closer towards us. I think that might be better. Okay, let's see. Where do I need to go for that wordstone? Okay, here it is. That is good enough for me, I guess, to waste the turn with him, pretty much, to just pick up all of the shards as well as one fragment. Still no cluster inside where we are, but getting a lot of shards is still really good. And if there is a cluster or two to be had, we might get that as a battleground reward at the end, assuming we do win. Which I'm going to assume. It's usually pretty standard. Objectives updated. But this being a brutal mission and the first one with an impressive in it, I'm still a bit worried. They're just very close already. Objective and we need to completed get a good engagement. Their impressive might just knock down our flagellant there. So I'm really not sure where I want to go with my impressive now. This is just so weird. Oh, come on, really? Tharik, get it together, buddy. I mean myself, of course. Okay, let's do this. And I need to make a decision regarding our impressive very soon, because this guy is just probably going to attack Tharik if he gets the chance. And I'm not really sure I want to let him. So that's 2, 4, 6. That's 3 attacks that he's going to deal out. He does have 7 offense points. So he has 1 more than we do. So what does Pyre of the Righteous do again? Melee and ranged hit chance. The effigy. I don't like this. But I'm going to delay. I need to act after the enemy impressive. I need them to come a little bit closer, otherwise I would overextend myself and we would just get slaughtered. Okay, he's setting up a pyre. And now he's coming in. Oh crap, that's a lot of damage. And I miss. And I didn't get to charge, which would have been nice. Okay, that's the second hit. And number 3 is probably going to take a... Oh, he misses. Ooh, that is so good. Okay. We have a chance. The problem is we can't quite get close enough with some of our units to reach there already. If I set up a pyre, I won't be able to reach, and I can't charge. I could charge, but that would mean losing out on one attack, which we probably don't want to do, so we are just going to engage him normally. Yeah. Here we go. Let's do this. Hit him. Hit him. Where it hurts. Oh no, I really can't afford to miss here. Oh boy. Oh, crit stun. Perfect. That is so good. That is going to cost him some attacks. And we do have a 60% dodge stance, which is pretty good, actually. He just starts with a ridiculously high amount of dodge. And just Delight Armor is taking care of that a bit. Corrosive Miasma. Nice. He is picking up some Wordstone. That is fine. We don't really need that Wordstone at the moment. The important thing is that he can't get into close combat with us. Hopefully. Okay, ambush stance. It's going to make it difficult for us to reach or to get more damage onto the impressive. But maybe? I don't think so, unfortunately. So we'll attack that guy just like that. Okay, let's go here. And engage there. Only one attack, unfortunately, with Ray. As we're still affected by Fervor. Oh boy. Yeah, this is a lot of damage. Immaculate Flesh really won't help us. And Peter probably can't make it in this turn. Just barely. He's just barely too slow. Okay, let's put him there. I don't really know if we can get a charge off like this, but it might be enough to close the gap. I don't know if he can get past there, but if that prevents them from being able to reach us there. Oh boy. And there he goes. I knew that would happen.
Objective.
That's the sacrifice we took there. And Peter didn't get the charge against this dude. Oh boy. So this really is not looking too good right now. This brutal mission might have been a mistake. The setup looked good, but the execution is lacking currently. Boy, we're just still so far back. But we might be able to... Really? Sort of charge stands there? I missed that somehow. But at least this guy is in our backyard now, but I need to hit him to actually be able to do anything here. And 1 out of 2 is okay, but 2 out of 2 would have been nicer.
A new round has started.
For obvious reasons. So let's see. I can't get a dodge on their impressive, but I can't get one there either. So do. No! I mean, Gift of Savagery is good, but still. Now. Oh no, I didn't use up my strategy point. That is good. Whew. Difficult question. Really difficult question. Yeah, let's attack the impressive. It's automatic hits now that he's stunned currently. Nice crit. Disengaging really won't help us. What does he do? Oh boy. Yeah, this is far from ideal currently. Okay, he is attacking our impressive. That is no big deal, especially if he keeps missing us. Wow, three misses in a row? We can't ask for much more there, I think. Whew. So, Leonhard. And we are not currently getting the optional objective, to be clear about that. So let's take down this guy. Do I want to charge him? 69% chance. Yeah, let's try. Okay, nice. Oh, the higher percent chance missed. It's just so unfortunate that their impressive is the first thing that came barreling through there. So how do we do this best? Could go here and attack that guy. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. Close this down for good, and it will make this a two-on-one engagement, which is nice. So that could turn out pretty helpful. But they have two units going next, and we'll have to wait and see what they end up doing. Because they can still go through the building. After just an ambush stance, that is not a big problem currently. And that guy is probably too far away to do anything if he even shows up. Okay, our turn. Let's set up a pyre. So how does that work exactly? A target location that can be destroyed by enemies, increase the chance of pass, blah 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 blah. For allies. Okay, so it's only allies. So we will set that up right. So that will get most of ours. And now I can attack, and we will focus our damage on their impressive. Another crit, that is really good. Did I mention that his accuracy stat is already really high as well? Oh, third crit. And that's all open wounds, so his hit chances are getting worse and worse. Wow, really? Three crits in a row? That is amazing. So this might turn out okay after all. At least all things considering. Okay, he recovers. It's one hit. 36% hit chance. 29% hit chance. He makes them both. Not what I wanted to see, but nothing we can do about that. This guy shouldn't be able to make it in. Okay. Let's see, Ristarik. Where do we want him to go? Probably right. I think this guy might run away if he gets the chance, and I might be blocking him here if that happens, but it's okay. Let's take it. I'm rather not take the chance, and we're dealing more damage this way. At least this way it's secure damage where he might not fail us all alone or just not run away, something like that. Okay, he succeeds us all alone, not what I wanted to see. So Ray is in trouble. Does he get two attacks? He shouldn't, and he doesn't. Okay, so Ray is sticking around for at least one more turn. And we do have two attacks again, so that's quite nice. Okay, perfect. And maybe our flagellant here will be able to finish the job very soon. Okay, Peter. Peter. We have two options now, pretty much. Going on their leader or on the hero there. Let's see if we can get a third one going. No, I cannot move through here, unfortunately. So I think I'm choosing to attack the hero, because we might take him down or get him very close to going down. Yeah, we're rather taking him close. And I think that's better for now. Three. Very good. And parry, please. That Pyre of the Righteous is really good, I think. And we're pretty much in there with almost everybody. At least everybody that is in close combat. There are two or three missing. Oh, all alone, success. He should get two attacks if he doesn't cast a spell, which he doesn't, but he stuns Black Orc. That's not nice. But Black Orc did already know he's just... So one attack, no chance of killing him, but we at least get rid of his dodge stance. And parry ourselves. So this brutal mission really is pretty challenging. Their damage is pretty insane. And this is just an extremely big cluster right off the bat. And we can be very lucky that they're not coming with everybody. That would just be too much. But that's just not how the brutal missions work.
A new round has
started. The AI should allow us to do stuff here. Okay, his dodge stance is just really high. 63% chance there. No big surprise that we missed. The important thing now becomes us being able to kill this guy before he does more damage. Let's see. Yeah? He keeps missing us. Okay, that's the first time. I shouldn't have talked. But still, he hit with 2 out of 6 attacks. Still a pretty bad average. And hopefully we can turn this around in our favor. So this guy going down will help. And he does. Perfect. So I can't loot him. Our inventory is full. And let us engage. Yeah, just because otherwise he's going to choose a target that is almost dead. I'm going to attack the guy that is right here in charge range and get charged by him. We should be able to take one more hit from him, and also we do have a 70% dodge stance, so he needs to hit us in the first place. Otherwise, I would have attacked their leader. But that doesn't really help us this turn. Okay, nice. That guy's toast. So he did pick that up. So
objective. Steal updated.
That. And now it also becomes a question of forcing the all-alone check here, which is what we're going to do with Klinger. Oh, he succeeds, the jerk. Hits Leonhard. No dodge there. Yeah, it happens. It's still okay. Fire Purge. And let's see. You really need to die, buddy. So one more hit and he should be toast. And I'm not only saying that because we have opened fire. And I did minimal damage, so he has one hit point left. But he is affected by fire purge, is that right? Did I see that correctly? Yeah, so on turn start he will take damage, so he will go down. So I don't need to attack him anymore. So we're going to attack the leader. And he got the fire purge debuff as well. That is awesome. Okay, good. I don't know if that's going to count as an enemy taken out of action for our impressive. Because we don't actually kill him. He just dies because of an effect we put on him. But I don't think that's how this works. But we'll see about that at the end here. Oh, who is he going to attack? He is getting... Oh, he's attacking the pyre. How many hit points does that thing have? Apparently quite a lot. Let's check that. How many hit points does that have? Can I not check that? Apparently not. So where are we attacking now? We can get more units on their leader. That guy is on the pyre. They are pretty close to routing, so I do need to make sure that I get my optional objective still, but I think we should attack here first. Whoop, dodging, you jerk. We can just take the loot that our dead flagellant dropped. I just need to move the other flagellant out of the way first. But let's loot here. No, he just doesn't have anything of use to us. So do I want to keep Ray around? That's the big question. He is pretty beat up already. The question is, can I get on here? If I can, I should probably, but we can't. So let's move. Yeah, now we're in there. Okay, it's fine. At least I can still dodge. But we also missed by 2%. And sometimes I still curse myself that I got used to the combat lock being open at all times, because if we miss by 2%, it's a little bit annoying, but it's also just part of the game. It's based on probabilities, so it happens that you miss some stupid rolls sometimes. So let's see, we still can do this with Peeta here. And we should have, or force them to check on for all alone by 1% there. On almost everybody that is in combat right now, but there's also still two enemies going who might change that. And here's where this might become problematic. Okay, just an ambush stance is good. Don't really understand why. Because he ran past two of my units to get there. Maybe he wanted to go for Ray and couldn't quite make it. Oh, they have a Templar Knight as well, who just is not getting in there. So Black Orc is... I am just going to parry with him. Because if I move at all, he's going to charge me and I'm going to die. If I ambush him, he's going to counterattack and I'm going to die. So I'm going to parry and choose to live. That is the general idea. Okay, so I can loot this. Oh yeah, we're already in there, so this doesn't help. So let's switch that out to get a shard. So I need to loot that with somebody else. Assuming we can do that. Their leader is right there. Let's go in there and force the all alone. This might make it impossible here for him to... to be able to loot stuff there, but that's fine. I'd rather force this guy into an all-alone check than get the optional objective, especially considering this is a brutal mission and we are pretty close with some of our units, so I'd rather have this a little bit safer. And let's see. All-alone, fail. Perfect. That's what we need. Oh god, Leonard, we need to take something out. Oh, nice crit. Because this guy is going next, I think, for them. And that crit is an open wound, which might be helpful, and we are just dangerously close here. And I really don't want to go down. He might also fail us all alone, with a little bit of luck. But we'll have to wait and see about that. Maybe we'll get lucky with him, the crit, and just stun him, and that would maybe prevent him from attacking, but nope. Not quite that lucky. And dodge. All alone, fail, perfect. Oh, that is so good. That flagellant coming in isn't good though. Where is he going? Ambush over there, that I don't care about. Yet, okay, Halfor. Do your thing. Let's set up a new pyre. Target area is blocked. Makes sense. So, I like this. We're still not hitting everybody, but we're hitting a bunch of ours. That's good enough for me. Oh, 95% hit chance. Still missing. You're not getting away that easily. Does the fire purge stack? I don't think so. Otherwise, that might be too strong. But who knows? And dodge. It's probably in the skill description, but I just can't remember. Okay, that's not good. Oh, but he attacks Peter. That is quite good, though. But he will have two attacks, but both of them go on Peter. Good. Let's see. Ristarek. Yeah, we're just... We keep attacking. We still haven't taken anybody else out. So they're still not below the threshold for routing. And this scares me a bit. Luckily, we still have a bunch of units that can do their attacks. Come on, Ray. Okay, we're getting closer again. But this guy... Well, actually, he might go down. Peter is going next. And with his three attacks, he should be able to do the job. That's one. That's two. And now I'd like to gather some Wordstone. But they're still not routing. Yeah, let's take those. So let's take a look here. I could go for that one fragment, which would be a star, but ideally I'd like to loot, but we can't get there. That's the wrong point. That's unfortunate. Okay, let's gather this one fragment.
Objectives updated.
Which means we only are missing one, but they're also still 1 point away from routing. So this is just getting really close. And we can get one hit in on the leader still. I still can't move with Black Orc. It's not happening. I just need to parry and hope that the guy here won't be able to do anything to me. Or maybe I should ambush and hope for the best? Or charge? No. I'm still going for the parry. I'm just too scared. I really can't move an inch with him. But he is... That loot action doesn't concern us. Yeah, oh, he missed Ray. I assumed he would go for Ray, which is why I was considering the ambush. But he missed, and so Ray is still alive. That is good. Where does their hero go, though? Oh, yeah, missing Ristarek. I'm really into it right now. Oh, this is so close. They're 1 point away from checking for the route. But their leader is almost dead, so I think we have a really good chance of making that happen. And let's see. That's one hit. And it just doesn't help me could disengage, but I don't think that's good enough. Let's do this. Okay. And now I'm going to delay with Eberhard. Because we need him to move out of the way and free up that loot point there. Once the leader is dead. Oh, Fire Purge actually does stack, so it's two attacks by that. That's pretty awesome. Really awesome, actually. Wow. Oh, crit on Halfor. That's okay, I guess. Let's see. Oh, we really can't afford to miss here right now. I need something to die. Thank you. That's better. And let's see, Leonhardt. He's full on Wordstone as well. So this really won't help him. Or his inventory is full in terms of Wordstone. So let's move over here. And engage there. For the all alone. Klinger. Delay. Oh no, that didn't help. But that works out okay. We can get Halfor the kill on the leader, hopefully. Perfect. And then we can also bait out the ambush here. Nice. So we should be okay in terms of getting the words done. And now it just becomes a question of do they run away or not. Because if they don't, things will get very tricky and close again. Because we have a bunch of units that are almost dead. He needs to delay one more time. Oh no, please tell me that doesn't put him... It puts him past the enemy. I'm stupid. This is not good. But we couldn't have looted otherwise. Ah, crap. Yeah, this might cost us the optional now. I'm dumb. No, they succeed their outtest. Makes me scared in a whole different way. He carries a one-handed weapon, so he will be able to attack twice, but he missed and then we dodge. Okay. So I can get that Wordstone. But can I keep it? Oh, crap. Now I ask myself, why did they have to succeed? Oh, this could turn around on us very quickly. Okay, get two shards.
Objective completed.
So who's still in here? And who's going next? That guy up there is going next. So let's present him with another target and just overall hit him. If only once, because of the Warpstone debuff, we can go for only one attack. And he might actually have room to run away and disengage, while I do not. The problem is that Templar Knight over there will kill the unit next attached to it. If we let him, the two-handed hammer deals too much damage. Oh, Black Orc. As much as I hate this, we need to... Is he immune to all alone? That's something I always forget about. Unwavering, immune to all alone, fear and terror. So I'm not going to give him a second target to hit. That's not a good idea. We should probably do this, even though it might cost us this unit if he doesn't fail us all alone. Oh, I don't like this one bit. I really don't. Fails is all alone. So he just doesn't do anything. Oh, but Pita is the perfect unit to put on there. Let's pick up this fragment real quickly. And what we can hope for now is that he will attack Pita exclusively. That's pretty much what I'm counting on. Because he can take the damage. While, is that Risterik? He might be. Definitely can't anymore. Come on, Pita, be the hero we need you to be. Soak up that damage. Oh, yes, he does. That's a parry fail, but that's okay. Okay, another hit. He shouldn't get more than two with that hammer. Okay, awesome. Oh, God. We got so lucky there.
A new round has started.
Whew, still not out of the woods, though. This guy is immune against all alone as well, and if he hits our impressive more, our impressive will go down. He's very close to dying as well. But we do get a bunch of hits against this guy first, and that will force them to check again. So if we can make that happen, that would be ideal. Yes, awesome. Okay, that is really good. Oh, we just put them at zero. Okay, that works too. And we got one cluster at least, so there was at least one on the map. Maybe more.
You are the instrument of Sigmar's justice.
Who?
Bringing his righteous wrath upon those who would sow their evil in the lands of men.
But that
such
one was
is the most
pretty
honor
exciting.
Faithful can embrace.
So we're going to have to deal with some light wounds as well as one unit being taken out of action. So that's going to be interesting, maybe.
Remarkable, remarkable.
Near-death experience. Actually pretty good because he gains extra experience, but his recovery time is just really high.
The gods are with you. Nice
see.
Progress.
That's just so much experience for everyone. Really, really nice.
Fantastic. Outstanding.
Okay, Ray getting there. Halfor. Let's see. Wow, 11 experience. Two enemies put out of action, so I think the fire debuff on the enemy impressive did count there. I think that's where the second one came from. And so we acquire a bunch of stuff. And we go from 97 Wordstone to 172. And I think we should send off all of the Wordstone that we have available to us right now. Because 700 isn't that much. And we can definitely use that. So let's send to Sigmar's Haven everything, or at least enough to put us, or I don't know if we can get the reputation threshold already. I don't think so. Nah, we're still ways off, but it will give us 1261 gold, and that is really good. So let's send the shipment. Sigmar's Haven, yes. Okay. And that will arrive in 2 days. Okay, really good. I might maybe go for a few cheap skills here before I move on to the next day, but we'll see about that. So that's where we're going to end the episode for today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more time, just subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you tune in next time, and have a nice day. Bye.